As we all know that Boeing has struggled since two crashes of its 737 MAX aircraft, which led to the plane being grounded indefinitely. Boeing has had its fair share of bad news surrounding the 737 MAX, and this was due to the software glitch which was responsible for two deadly crashes in a span of 5 months. And post those two accidents, Boeing hasn't sold any 737 MAX in months, as the plane has been grounded for more than half a year. Boeing CEO says he still expects the 737 MAX planes to return to service in the fourth quarter of 2019, but regulators across the globe may not clear it for flight at the same time. It would be done in a phased manner. According to the analysts, a formal submission of the MAX upgrades to the Federal Aviation Administration is expected in September 2019, with the hopes that the plane will return to service at least by October or November 2019. When this announcement was made, or when this news came out, the Boeing shares were up about 3%. Now let's see what actually the fix was. As you all know, both the Lion Air accident, which happened in October 2018, and the Ethiopian Airlines crash, which happened in March 2019, it was due to a system called MCAS. It was a sensor which was fixed as a fix for the problem created by installing bigger engines in these Boeing 737 MAX. And according to the latest update from sources, the manufacturer has developed a software fix for the jets. The European Union Aviation Safety Agency and the Federal Aviation Administration counterpart in Europe said the questions remained about the angle of attack sensor on the planes. The erroneous data from these sensors were implicated in both 737 MAX crashes, in which a flight control software called MCAS automatically pushes the nose of the plane downward when it senses a stall. Among Boeing's changes to the flight control system, known as MAX, is to feed its data from two sensors instead of one in case they are providing inaccurate information. Boeing CEO mentioned that it would not need any hardware changes, but can be fixed with simulators and software. So now, will the plane start flying worldwide once a green light is given? Not necessarily, and not immediately too. Pilots and their trade unions will need to be convinced of the modifications being done, and the captains and first officers will require additional training on the changes made by Boeing. There is also possibility that the Federal Aviation might give permission for a return to service, while other global aviation regulators will not. And in addition to this, the pressure is also from the victim families, since they are demanding more safety tests before giving a green signal for these Boeing 737 MAX. So let's wait and see what the next update on this Boeing 737 MAX is going to be. Hope you liked this video. Please do subscribe my channel and hit the bell button next to it. Feel free to leave a comment in the comment section as well. Thank you.